Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2068, Ways to Clear in VBA. I got a bit of a mystery today, one comment left on one of my YouTube videos from Roger. I want to clear text in a given array of cells, but not the formatting. And Roger says, with the dot clear contents, it clears everything in the cells. Is it possible to create a macro to clear only the text and generate the next invoice number? So he wants to clear only the text from cells. And there are several different ways to clear in VBA. Let me switch over here to Alt F11 where we take a look at all of them. So there's dot clear, which should clear everything, clear comments, clear contents, clear formats, clear hyperlinks, clear notes, and clear outline. So I've created some data here, and you see that I'm going to each individual column and running the various different VBA methods. All right, so dot clear got rid of everything. Dot clear comments, you see there's a comment right here that hopefully will go away. Yep. Dot clear contents. All right, see, now that didn't get rid of the borders or the fill colors, and we'll circle back to this one in a bit. Clear formats leaves the numbers, gets rid of the formatting. Clear hyperlinks should have gotten rid of the hyperlink, but it did not. Interesting. Clear notes is like clear comments. Remember, comments were called notes in the original version, and then clear outline got rid of our outline for all of the rows. All right, so those are the options that we have. And personally, I like clear contents because clear contents gets rid of the numbers, but leaves the formatting. Right, I just typed 1, 2, 3, 4, press Control Enter, and all of the superscript, the strike through, fill color, number formatting, all of that stuff stays. So in my opinion, clear contents is the good one. It's the one that keeps all of your formatting there, all the borders there, but just gets rid of the value. So I'm a bit perplexed with Roger's question because it seems like clear contents should be the one that's doing what he's doing. Although I wonder if what Roger really wants to do is get rid of the things that aren't formulas. All right, so here I'm going to do show formulas with control in the grob accent, and you see that we have contents in, or constants in B, C, and G, but then formulas in D, E, and F. And I wonder if Roger's trying to get rid of the text but leave the formulas there. All right, and if that's the situation, then we want to go one step beyond this, all right, where we specify the entire range of B5 to G13. And before we do the clear constants, we want to say dot special cells, Excel cell type constants. So in other words, if it's a formula, leave it alone. When we run this macro, you'll see that the constants go away, but all of the formulas are still there. Now, I should have wrapped them in if error to make them not appear as an A, but it keeps the formulas there. I'm not sure. I'm a bit perplexed with Roger's question, because to me it seems like clear contents should be doing what it's doing. But there's all of the options. Now, this book doesn't cover VBA, but it covers a lot of other things. Brand new book that just came out, Power Excel with Mr. Excel. Click that I in the top right hand corner to take a look at that. All right, so wrap up of this episode, how to clear in VBA. There's 7 different methods available. Clear will clear everything, just the comments, keeps the formatting, clears the values and formulas, gets rid of just the formatting, gets rid of just the hyperlinks. Second way to clear comments, because comments used to be called notes. Clear outline gets rid of the group and outline groups, and then there at the end we use special cells to select only constants or only formulas, and then clear contents there. Well, hey, I want to thank Roger for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.